Song of Songs. Hark, my lover, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks. He says to me, arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. O my dove, from the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet. And you are lovely. My lover belongs to me, and I to him. He says to me, set me as a seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm. For stern as death is love, relentless as the netherworld is devotion. Its flames are a blazing fire, deep waters cannot quench love, nor floods sweep it away. The word of the Lord. Let all praise the name of the Lord.
Let all praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all you angels. Praise him, all you hosts.
Let all praise the name of the Lord.
Let all praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens, all you waters above the heavens.
Let all praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
You mountains and all you hills, you fruit trees and all you cedars, you wild beasts, all tame animals, creeping things, and wicked fowl.
Let all praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Let the kings of the earth and all the peoples, princes and all the judges of the earth, young men, human beings, old men and boys, praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted.
Let all praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
His majesty is above earth and heaven. He has lifted his horn above the people.
Let all praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered, nor does it brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It dares all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. While there is knowledge, it will be passed away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I put away the things of childhood. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall see and know fully, even as I am fully known. Now these three things remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord. God for a share in their blessing today.
a great day. This is a day of jubilance, of blessings running over. Ask God to give you a taste of that and to continue to bless Tara and God. And for those of you, and there are a few of you who are too young to be concerned about marriage, ask God to bless Tara and God as you continue to enjoy your life. That's what we want from you today. To enjoy this day, to enjoy this liturgy, to enjoy the reception that's going to take place afterwards, but most of all, to enjoy this wonderful witness that we're about to partake in. And I said last night at the rehearsal, this is the only sacrament I, as a priest, don't get to do. And you think, well, I probably did you don't get married. No, that's not what I mean. I can baptize, I can confirm, I get the church Eucharist. You know, I would write the guardian of six. But I don't get to do a marriage. They get to do the marriage. The couple themselves, out of their love, bring their baptismal bond to this church, and together they make the marriage happen. They make the sacrament happen. I'm only listed as a witness. I'm the witness that I saw this thing happen. And what a beautiful thing that happened. What a beautiful thing today represents. Something that they began so long ago. And even though it's only been a few years, it survived the test of time. And they came to me and said, we want to do it. Let's do it. And so you're invited to be just like me at this point, a witness to love. A witness to the love that they have for each other, but a witness of love that comes from God. There can be no greater witness to love than love that comes from God. Now let me go talk to them. Now the book
this is where Jesus does his first ever sermon. Does he think he's going to have to do a miracle here for yourself? Exactly. He has to write out.
Because it is a miracle that God brings two people so totally different from two different backgrounds and brings them together.
my dear friend. You have come together in this church so that the Lord may feel and strengthen your love and the presence of this church minister and this community. Christ has come and blessed us in his life. He's already consecrated both of you by the name of baptism, and now he's going to give you this special sacrament so that you may have filled with the Spirit and the usual and lasting fellowship. And so now I ask you in the presence of the church to come to the altar and take care of you.
Amen.
forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
before you. And in your promise of love, watch over those who have joined the sacramental covenant.
We ask you for Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your heart. Let us be thankful, Lord our God. Have been in the covenant with your people, so that you have redeemed man and woman by the ministry of Christ's death and resurrection. So in Christ, you might make the partakers a divine nature and go ahead with them of heavenly gifts. In the union of heaven and earth, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more and more deeply to the wondrous design of your love. And so the angels and saints, we proclaim the end of your praise as we do our wedding. Brought up for you and for me, for the forgiven of sin, to live in thy great kingdom.
Our Father, our Lord, our Lord, our Lord. Then I will come down and invite any Catholic who desires.